Hello everyone, myself Dr. Kirti Mathur. I am MPT Musculoskeletal, presently working as Assistant Professor, Department of Physiotherapy, Dolphin PJ Institute of Biomedical and Natural Sciences. Today I am going to give a lecture on the POA technique, and this is a technique which is used to treat certain conditions by using ultraviolet radiations. And POA is an acronym, and the P stands for sorolin, the U for ultra, V for violet, and the A for that portion of the solar spectrum between 320 and 400 nanometers in wavelength. So POA stands for sorolin ultraviolet A, means we are using a drug sorolin along with the ultraviolet A radiation. Sorolins are chemicals which are found in certain plants that have the ability to absorb ultraviolet light in the UVA portion of the solar spectrum. So it is basically increasing the sensitivity towards the ultraviolet radiations. Once the light energy is absorbed, these sorolins are energized to interact with DNA, ultimately inhibiting cell multiplication, which is its presumed mode of action. And the sorolin, which is 8-methoxysorolin, 8-MOP, or it is also called as oxsorolin, this is used for the treatment of psoriasis along with the exposure of ultraviolet light in the UVA spectrum. Now we have different types of POA therapy. The most common form of therapy combines 8-methoxysorolin taken by mouth, followed by 45 to 60 minutes later by exposure of the skin to UVA. And less commonly, the drug is applied topically. The medication is occasionally diluted in a bathtub water in which the patient is immersed, and then after a few minutes, the ultraviolet exposure occurs. POA actually does not cure psoriasis. It is basically controlling the symptoms of the condition. So we are using this sorolin ultraviolet A therapy in different methods. One in which we have given a medicine to the patients 45 to 60 minutes prior to the treatment, means prior to exposure to ultraviolet radiations. And second method is we have mixed the medication in a bathtub and patient is immersed in the bathtub. Then what are the advantages and disadvantages of POA? So the major advantage of PUVA or POA is that it is an effective therapy that becomes active only at the site of exposure. It can be used to treat large areas of skin, and the fact that the drug is only activated in the presence of ultraviolet light implies that it may be less toxic than other therapies that require systemic administration and whose effects are not localized to just the skin. So it becomes active only when a patient is exposed to ultraviolet radiation. So otherwise it is in the inactive form, so it has got less side effects. Then administration of technique. So when we start treating a patient with POA technique, sorolin is given 45 to 60 minutes prior to the ultraviolet light exposure, and this medication increases the sensitivity or solar activity. And the amount of sorolin is based on the weight of the patient. The length of exposure depends on the degree of patient's pigmentation, means how much amount of sorolin is given and how much length of exposure is given to a patient. This depends on the patient's pigmentation, while dose depends on the weight of the patient. Accordingly, the darker patient, the longer the exposure time, because they have melanin pigment which prevents the effect of the ultraviolet radiation. So in that case, we need to increase the exposure time. Depending on the equipment used, the exposure may occur in a metal light box surrounding the patient with the bulbs that run vertically and are generally 48 inches long and resemble fluorescent bulbs. So this is a cabinet which has got different tubes which are arranged vertically, and patient is sent inside this chamber for the treatment purpose. In this, you can see this patient is going inside this chamber, and you can see that eyes are protected and these genital organs are protected, otherwise rest of the body is exposed for the ultraviolet radiations. And this can be used for various skin disorders like psoriasis, vitiligo, then some cancerous and precancerous conditions, skin related cancer symptoms, then hyperbilirubinemia and jaundice, mood and sleep disorders. All these conditions can be treated by PUVA technique. And then we'll see how many PUVA treatments are required. There ought to be a significant improvement in patient's skin disease after 15 treatments, and treatments are given no sooner than 48 hours apart, because the burn induced by PUVA is often delayed for as long as 2 days, because it is actually creating effect of ultraviolet radiation on the skin. So if we give it continuously, then it can cause further burn like condition to the patient. So it is usually given after a gap of 48 hours. Unless there is a problem, the amount of energy administered to the patient is increased appropriately at each visit depending on the patient's coloration, and after about 30 treatments, a decision is made as to whether to continue treatment or not, and this depends on the patient condition also. PUVA is not always effective. If there is no improvement after these treatments, it is probably unlikely that continuing this form of treatment is worthwhile. On the other hand, if significant clearing has occurred, it is probably prudent to decrease the frequency of treatment in order to maintain the improvement. Means if we have got the improvement, we need not to increase the doses. We'll continue with that, and then progressively we will decrease the doses. Since there is a relationship between the amount of light energy administered and the degree of photoaging and the induction of skin cancers, it is wise to limit the light exposure as appropriate. Then coming on to the side effects, if overdose is given and long exposures are given, it can cause skin cancer. Then photoaging, which is seen with everyone when we are exposed to a lot of sunlight, which results into dry and wrinkling of the skin. And if not appropriately monitored, it can produce severe ultraviolet light burns. And occasionally, sorolin can cause nausea, so susceptible patients take the drug with the food. Now coming on to the calculation of doses, if we have calculated the even dose, even is determined from the skin test, and the other arrhythmal doses can be calculated with this. So if we are giving a subarrhythmal, then it will be subarrhythmal means below to the minimal arrhythmal dose, and subarrhythmal of 75% of even, while E2 dose is 2.5 times of even dose, E3 is 5 times of even dose. In the same way, E4 is 10 times of even dose, and double E4 is 20 times of even, while E4 and double E4 are used on the open wounds. Then when we need to progress the doses, we'll follow this formula, like even dose, previous dose plus 25%, while giving E2 dose, then previous dose plus 50%, and E3 dose is previous dose plus 75%. Doses is used on open wounds are not progressed, because there is no epidermis to thicken, so we have to take care while treating open wounds. And then there is a formula for alteration of intensity with distance. So to irradiate a smaller area, the source is moved nearer to the patient, but the time of exposure must be altered to maintain the same intensity in accordance with the law of inverse square, which shows that new time means we have changed the distance, so how much long we have to give the ultraviolet light exposure, means we have to calculate the new time if we have changed the distance. So it will be calculated like old time multiplied by square of the new distance divided by the square of the old distance. So this was all about how we apply this PUVA technique, different types of PUVA technique, its advantages and disadvantages, and dose progression. Thank you so much.